Hi friends, my name is Kalpesh and welcome to my official YouTube channel Automotive Crux. In this video, I'm going to discuss the 10 multiple choice question for the carburetor which falls under the category of internal combustion engine, which is also known as an IC engine. I have already uploaded one video regarding the construction details of the simple carburetor. If you haven't visited yet, I'm kindly requesting to go through that video before you watch this video. Link for that video has been given into this description below, so click on it and enjoy it. Moreover, I would like to request you guys that if you haven't subscribed this channel, kindly requesting to click on the subscribe button, and simultaneously I'm also requesting to click on the bell icon which is next to the subscribe icon. You will get all the notification whenever I upload some stuff on my YouTube channel. So please subscribe this channel and enjoy the videos regarding the automotive technology. Let's discuss the multiple choice question for the carburetors. The first question is, venturi in the carburetor results in. We have four options, which are decrease of the air velocity, increase of the air velocity, decrease of fuel flow, increase of manifold vacuum. As I said, if you have visited my previous video about the construction detail of the simple carburetor, you guys are very well aware with the construction detail of the venturi. The venturi shape in the carburetor, it will be look like this. So the venturi in the carburetor or carburetor results in, we will think about the first option, decrease of air velocity. The venturi, it works on the Bernoulli's principle. The first portion, it will behave like a nozzle. So decrease of air velocity, it is the wrong option. Increase of air velocity, definitely it can be. Due to the nozzle shape, the fluid which is moving through this venturi, in our case it's air, the pressure starts decreasing and velocity starts increasing as per the Bernoulli's theorem. Decrease of fuel flow, in venturi the fuel gets entered at this point. So decrease of fuel flow, it is not relevant. And increase of manifold vacuum, this is completely irrelevant, because manifold vacuum, it depends on the speed of engine or the vacuum generated by the engine. So the correct answer, you can say it is the second option, increase of air velocity. The next question, the choke is closed when the engine is accelerating, engine is running hot, engine is running at cold, or engine is running at idling condition. In normal running condition, we kept choke valve in open condition, and we are operating choke valve during the cold weather condition. While we are operating the choke valve, we are trying to close it. Focus guys, we are trying to close it, not to open it. So during the cold weather condition, by operating the choke valve lever, we are trying to close it and we are trying to enrich the air fuel mixture. Accelerating condition, it is not a proper condition, because we are not operating the choke valve lever during the acceleration. Hot weather condition, again during the hot weather condition, engine demands the lean mixture, so that is the wrong option. And idling, again it is the wrong option. So our answer is the cold weather condition. The third question is, lean air mixture is required during. Now focus on this word, lean. We need to aware with the three types of mixture: lean, rich and stoichiometric air fuel mixture. Lean mixture, that means in that particular mixture the fuel particles are less as compared to the stoichiometric air fuel ratio. So here the question is, lean air mixture is required during, so at which condition the engine demands the lean mixture. We have four options: idling, starting, accelerating and cruising. During the idling condition, engine demands the rich mixture to start the vehicle from the completely stopped condition, engine demands the rich mixture. As I said, to start the vehicle, engine demands the rich mixture again. And when we are trying to accelerate the vehicle, all of a sudden, again, to achieve the demanded speed, our engine demands the rich mixture. So the only option is cruising. Cruising, it is, we can say, vehicle is running at constant speed. During constant speed, our engine demands the lean mixture. So the right answer is, cruising. Cruising is the right answer. The next question is, in SI engine for maximum power, the relative fuel air ratio is, we have four options, 1.5, 1.2, 0.8, 0.6. The correct answer is 1.5. The next question is, for maximum thermal efficiency, the maximum thermal efficiency, the fuel air mixture in SI engine should be. The question is about the thermal efficiency. Now, thermal efficiency we can define as the work output divided by the heat supplied. So, for maximum thermal efficiency, either we need to maximize the work output or we need to minimize the heat supplied. So, if we are looking for the options, we have four options. First, it is known as a lean mixture. Then, second one, it is rich stoichiometric, maybe lean or rich. Now, as I said, either we need to maximize the work output or we need to minimize the heat supply. Here, the four options, they are not relevant to the work output. They are relevant to the heat supply. How? Depends on the types of mixture available inside the engine. The engine liberates the heat, and that heat it is utilized to produce the work output. So if we are talking about the rich mixture, then the fuel particles will be higher, and if fuel particles will be higher, the heat supplied will be higher. Likewise, stoichiometric, as compared to lean mixture, the heat supplied in this case will be higher. Maybe lean or maybe rich, that is completely irrelevant option. Answer for this question is lean mixture. The next question is, for petrol engines, the method of governing is, the straightforward answer in petrol engine or all type of engine, we are measuring the fuel in quantity, which we are calling it the average, okay, fuel consumption. So the straightforward answer is quantity governing. The next question is, which is not an essential part of the simple carburetor? Now again, I would like to emphasize to click on the link provided into the description for a video named Constructional Detail of the Carburetor. So you will get the better knowledge about the basic essential parts and auxiliary parts for the simple carburetor. So we have options like fuel strainer, float chamber, the choke and the throttle valve, and compensating jet. Fuel strainer, it is the essential parts for any type of carburetor because they restrict the foreign particles and avoids the damages. Float chamber, it is also the essential part. It will behave like a small reservoir for the fuel in between the fuel tank and the venturi. The choke and throttle valve, the choke valve helps to vary the air fuel mixture. It helps to vary the fuel air ratio, and throttle valve, it helps to control the engine speed by controlling the amount of mixture supplied. So these three, they are compulsory required for any kinds of simple carburetor. This compensating jet, it is the auxiliary or additional jet provided for any carburetor to compensate the specific demands which is generated by the engine. So this is not an essential part. So the answer is D, compensating jet. This is the answer. The next question is, economizer in carburetor is utilized. Economizer In carburetor, it's slightly misleading word. Generally, economizer, it is relevant with the economy. Economizer in carburetor, it enrich the fuel air mixture during the special demand created by the engine. So the answer is A. To enrich the fuel air mixture, economizer is utilized. The next question is, which is not a function of the main metering system? Again, main metering system, it is the essential part of the simple carburetor. So the options are to proportion the fuel air mixture. We are discussing about the function of main metering system. So again, I would like to repeat, the options are to proportion the fuel air mixture, to decrease the pressure at the discharge nozzle exit, to limit the airflow at full throttle, and the last option is to make the mixture leaner as the throttle opens progressively. The first three, to proportion the air fuel mixture, to decrease the pressure at the discharge nozzle exit, to limit the airflow at full throttle. These three are the main function of the main metering system. But the question is, which is not a function of the main metering system? So the answer is D, to make the mixture leaner as throttle opens progressively. This is the function of compensating jet. So the answer is D. The last question is, which one is a constant choke type carburetor? We have four options: SU carburetor, Carter carburetor, Solex carburetor, and multiple Venturi carburetor. The Solex carburetor, it is the only carburetor, simplest type carburetor, which is a constant choke type carburetor. So the answer is C. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video with the attention. I would like to request again and again to subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon, so you will get all the notification. And if you like it, don't forget to share with your friends. Thank you so much.